Blake Caparello joined Australian Boxing Central. Fresh off victory against Reece Papuni, mate. What an absorbing battle that was. You know, it was looking like early after a little bit of a leg injury that
round three
like it might sort of end early. But what a chin he had, mate. He took a lot of shots from you.
Yeah, definitely took some big shots and kept coming back, kept swinging back. So I had to be safe in my defence as well. Couldn't be sloppy, which I try to maintain. And just bring the power. Doesn't matter. I just keep hitting him all night long. So it was a good blowout for me.
And I guess we saw, you know, something a little bit different from you, Blake, in the sense that, you know, you're such a clean, neat boxer, but you really sort of rolled the sleeves up tonight, got down and dirty, and really made a really entertaining battle for everyone in attendance at the pavilion tonight.
Like you said, I could have done my clinical boxing session, put the combos together, work on the outside, but, you know, we thought we'd dig deep and we'll gut it out with him and show, hey, we can do both. We can fight on the inside, we can fight on the outside, we do whatever we have to do. So, you know, put him back on the back foot and, yeah, he found the part himself.
And of course tonight you had to defend your WBA Oceania strap, as part of that, you know, obviously to maintain rankings and to continue sort of make the climb up the rankings, I guess. What's sort of next for you, mate? Are you sort of looking to fight again towards the end of this year or have a bit of a break?
No, I definitely want to fight. I want a big fight by the end of the year. There's a Callum Johnson. If I can't get a world title shot, you know, there's a Callum Johnson's. I know it's all good, that Joshua Buatsi. There's some good names there in the, Aleida Alvarez is, he lost to Kovalev, hasn't fought since.
Yep.
So there's some, and now Pascal.
Yeah.
Just pulled up a big upset as well. So there's some good names up there. If I can't get a world title shot, I think I deserve, title eliminator, one of these names. So I'm ready for it. I think I've grown as a fighter since I lost to Chilembra, a year and a half ago. So hopefully we get something big at the end of the year.
And being, you've had, there are about 30 pro fights now and, a real sort of veteran of the sport. When you sort of get to that point in your career, does every opportunity become even more important? You feel like you've got to really take it with both hands? And does it make you even hungrier?
Definitely, because now I'm up to 30-odd fights now, so I've had a couple of shots previously and, they've let them slip and I've built myself back up. Now I think I'm probably mature in my body, in my boxing. Now I've shown I can do inside work, outside work, hold my ground, not run all the time. So I think now, once I get my opportunity, I'm definitely going to take it.
And of course, an extra mouth to feed as well. I mean, yeah. I think it was your first child, daughter.
Yeah.
How many months ago was that?
9 months now.
How's fatherhood treating you?
Yeah, it's great. I love it. Just go home to your daughter, something different. So, got another mouth to feed and just want to make her happy. That's the main thing. So, your family's everything. Got to fight for her. Definitely wouldn't want to get in this game anyway. So,
and you speaking of family being everything, we know down at Team LaBruna, obviously Sam being the trainer and, lots of buzz around your gym at the moment. Obviously, you've been, one of the top rated light heavyweights, certainly within Australia and on world level for a while now. You've got Michael Zarafa, Shanika Johnson, who won tonight. You guys are making a lot of noise in Australian boxing.
Definitely. We've got a good team back home, back in East Kilda now. So, even Nix has come along and she's showed off tonight as well. So, and Benny, little Benny's he's the next one coming through. But like I said, in the ring, August 31st, now we focus on, August 9th, we focus on me, Nix and Benny. Now it's Michael's turn. So, hopefully everyone can get behind him and we can pull up an upset against Jeff Horn.
Beautiful, Blake. Well, it was great watching you tonight, mate. Absorbing battle and, bruising and, everything that the fans love to see. And, of course, we'll keep a close eye on what's next for you, mate. But well done on
Thank you very much and appreciate Oz Boxing Central all the time. Thank you.